So in the last class we discussed about types of circulations and evaluation in the transport systems. Okay. So now the continuation, today we are going to discuss about blood pressure, coagulation of blood. So before going into the concept, I want to say you one fact, children. So in the human body, especially our circulatory system can move 1 ml blood from heart to foot and again reverse back in how much time, you know? Roughly it is 2 meters distance to carry 1 ml of blood from heart to your foot and again reverse back. So roughly how much distance, children? 2 meters distance. Yeah, the whole process, it takes how much time, you know? Just 60 seconds, 1 minute. So see, just you imagine how fast the whole process will happen inside. Okay, as soon as it pumps the blood, it moves towards the foot and again it bring back within 1 minute. Okay, but the same process, if it occurs through diffusion process, you know, it takes 60 years of the time. So how horrible. That's what diffusion is not preferable to us. Okay, if the same 1 ml of blood to send from heart to your foot and to reverse back through the diffusion process, how many years time it takes? 60 years of the time. Okay, so that's what diffusion is not possible in the higher animals. Okay, so now we move on to the first concept, blood pressure. So every time when we ask the question, do you have BP? Every student will say, no, I didn't have BP. Okay. So we should not say we didn't have BP. You know, children, without BP, we can't survive. Okay. Everybody must have the normal BP. Okay. Everybody must require the BP. What is BP? Blood pressure. Without blood pressure, blood can't move inside the blood vessels. So never say I don't have BP. You have to say I didn't have either high BP or a low BP complaint. I have normal BP. Okay. I hope you all clear this. So let me say, what is blood pressure? Blood pressure nothing but, so when the, suppose if you take it is a blood vessel, if you take it is a blood vessel, when the blood flows in a blood vessel, when the blood flows in blood vessel, the blood vessel exerts some pressure on the walls. Okay, the blood exerts some pressure on the walls of the blood vessel. Okay, this is the wall of the blood vessel and this is the blood. So when the blood flows inside the blood vessel, it exerts some pressure on the walls of the blood vessel. That pressure we can say as a blood pressure. Okay, this pressure compulsory required to flow the blood in the blood vessels. Okay, the normal BP is 120/80, children. So here the 120 indicates systolic pressure, 120 indicates systolic pressure and 80 denotes diastolic pressure. Okay, so we already discussed systole means what? Contraction phase of the heart. So when the heart contracts, obviously blood flows forcibly. That's what systolic pressure is higher, 120. Diastolic means what I said, resting phase. So blood flows little slow. That's what diastolic pressure is low, 80. So if your BP is 120/80, 120 means what? 120 denotes systolic pressure, whereas 80 denotes diastolic pressure. So 120/80 is the normal blood pressure. So then what is high BP and what is low BP? High BP nothing but your blood pressure shows more than 120/80. For example, can you guess 150/100? Suppose your BP is showing like this. So 150 is that top one is always systolic, down one is always diastolic. So can we say it is a high BP? Yes, compulsory we can say high BP. If these readings are more than the normal, if they are more than 120/80, we can say it is a high BP. Like example, 160/110 or 170/110, okay, 150/100, we already given here, no, 150/90, So which is, suppose if the systolic is higher, automatically diastolic also higher. So that is called high blood pressure. And what is low blood pressure? So now easily you can guess, which is if the readings are less than the normal. For example, 110 by 70, okay, 100 by 60, like this. If your readings are less than the normal blood pressure, then that is called as low BP. But we should not have either high blood pressure or low blood pressure. Okay, so if you maintain the normal blood pressure, you will be healthy forever. So how can we maintain normal blood pressure, children? By having good diet. Okay, regular exercise, having balanced diet keeps our blood pressure always in a normal. Okay, but our BP is not all the situations in a same manner, because in some times, like while you are running, while you are doing vigorous exercises, while you are very tense time, your BP may be increases, but is just it is for fraction of seconds or some time only. Later again it becomes down. But if you persistently for a long period you have the higher blood pressure or a high BP or a lower BP, then it is the problem for your health. So when you are doing any exercise, any some particular situations your BP is fluctuating, means it is not a abnormal thing. But maximum duration your BP is either high or low means that is problem for your health. So try to maintain your blood pressure normally. It always keeps you healthy. Okay, so that is a topic about the blood pressure. So now the last concept, we are going to move to coagulation of blood. Okay, so now we move on to the topic coagulation of blood. Coagulation, when generally coagulation will happen? So when we faced any type of injuries. Okay, actually is it useful for us, children? Definitely. So we all come across many injuries in our life, especially childhood, when while you are playing, during small cuts and wounds, so much blood will ooze out of our body, right? So during that time you can notice how the coagulation is going to take place. So coagulation is really very very important character. Okay, so why? Because it is useful for all animals to survive when they meet any severe injuries. If there is no coagulation process, what will happen, children? So much blood will ooze out of our body, and sometimes even it leads to death. Okay, you can feel very happy. Coagulation is very very useful for us at the time of injuries. Okay, so during the time of injuries, blood nearly takes around 3 to 6 minutes for the formation of clot, children. Okay, to form the clot, how much time it requires? 3 to 6 minutes. Okay, suppose if the clot is not forming within 3 to 6 minutes, so maybe we have some deficiency of some vitamins. So we know already in first lesson you learned it, vitamin K will help us a lot. Okay, and one of the blood, one of the important blood cells, what are the blood cells will play vital role here? Blood platelets, also called thrombocytes, play very important role in the coagulation process. Okay, so if any deficiency is there, only by that time it may be delayed. But if you are healthy, if everything is fine in your body, so the blood clots within 3 to 6 minutes. Okay, so now there is a lot of chemical reactions will takes place at the time of formation of clot. So let me say one by one. So in the first step, children, as soon as injury is formed, immediately our blood platelets play vital role. Immediately blood platelets releases an enzyme named as thrombokinase. Okay, as soon as any injury formed, immediately produces an enzyme. Which enzyme? Thrombokinase. Okay, so after, then what the thrombokinase will do, it's a chain of reactions. Immediately this thrombokinase act on another substance present in our blood. The name of the substance is what? Prothrombin. Okay, it immediately reacts with prothrombin and it converts prothrombin into another substance, thrombin. Okay, so see, it's a linked up. First reaction, blood platelets release an enzyme called as thrombokinase. Immediately thrombokinase acts on prothrombin and converts prothrombin into thrombin. Okay, so now this prothrombin acts on another substance called as fibrinogen. Actually, fibrinogen also present in our blood, but it is in a soluble state. Means what? It mixes with the blood. We can't identify it before. It was soluble in the blood. So now this thrombin acts on. Okay, this thrombin acts on fibrinogen, which is actually in a soluble state. Soluble means what? Which is mixed with the blood. And it converts this fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin fibers. Till that time, we didn't find them. They were mixed with the blood. Now, fine fiber-like structures we can see, like thread-like structures. Suppose if your cloth was torn, how your mummy will use thread for knitting, right? In the same manner, these fibers are very important for us to repair that particular injured part. Okay, so these fibrin fibers are formed with the help of thrombin. So continuously a chain like process. So now these fibrin fibers, what they will do? Immediately these blood cells will entangle the fibrin fibers and then slowly clot is going to form. Okay, this whole process takes how much time? Within 3 to 6 minutes. In some people may be 3 and some people may be 6. Maximum duration 6 minutes. So once again, as soon as injury happened, first what happened? Blood platelets will immediately react and produce an enzyme called as thrombokinase. Thrombokinase. This thrombokinase immediately acts on another substance called as prothrombin and convert prothrombin into thrombin. Okay. So now thrombin will act on soluble fibrinogen material. Actually, it is in a soluble state. Now, this thrombin will help to convert fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin fibers. So, once the fibers ready, then so the whole task is completed. Immediately, blood cells mix with these fibrin fibers and clot is going to form. Okay. So, in this way, coagulation of blood also very, very useful for us. Okay, for the survival, to protect us from the severe injuries. And the final conclusion, so once the clot is formed, children, just you notice, sometimes maybe you get hurts, no? So after formation of clot, on the top of the clot, white liquid layer you can find. Okay, that white layer is called as serum. Okay, this is called as a serum. The white layer which is formed on the top of the clot is called as serum. Actually, serum is colorless, children. So related to blood, children, you have to remember two important terms. One is serum. Serum is actually formed after formation of the clot. Okay. And the second term is plasma. Plasma is collected when the blood is not allowed to clot, children. Suppose if you want plasma, what we can do? Generally, in all laboratories, they used to do. Okay. They used to collect the blood in a test tubes. And then they will add some anticoagulants. Okay. Those anticoagulants are useful to not, they won't allow the blood to clot. So when they add anticoagulant, after some time you can see clearly the yellow fluid will reach us top of the test tube and bottom some sediment will be settled down. So the bottom sediment is blood cells. The top yellow fluid is the plasma. Okay. So remember, plasma is yellow in color, whereas serum is colorless. Okay, serum is color. Serum generally formed after formation of clot, whereas plasma is formed when blood is not allowed to clot. Okay, so I hope you all understood. So by this we concluded the concept of transportation in animals. Okay, so once again try to answer some questions. What is blood pressure? And what is normal blood pressure? And during blood pressure, okay, we missed one point, children. Sorry, that point is, how can we know the blood pressure, children? Sphygmomanometer. Anyone knows? Generally, people used to call it as a BP machine. You should not say BP machine. It has a specific term. What is that? Sphygmomanometer. Okay, with the help of sphygmomanometer, we can measure the blood pressure. Okay, now you have to answer which device used to measure the BP and what is the normal blood pressure. Okay, then how coagulation will form. Okay, and how much time the coagulation takes. So try to answer all these questions and prepare well. Thank you.